Welcome back to the show. Now, the Associated Press said our next guest is a glorious amalgamation of grunge chords, killer grooves, screaming Jay Hawkins theatrics, a healthy sense of humor, and great pop melodies. Well, that's quite a mouthful, but he sure lives up to it. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Webb Wilder. My friend.
Fine, and yourself?
Good. No Great Shakes.
No Great Shakes.
That's on the new Watermelon CD.
Exactly. Acres of Suede.
Yeah, let me show that right away so we can just let everybody see. It's called Where'd you get the title? Acres of Suede.
There is a story. It may be boring. I got really big feet, folks, and my...
What size?
These are 13 A's, but a 14 A isn't embarrassed to get close to me.
That's acres of suede, all right.
Acres, I had some jogging shoes and my producer said, boy, those are some acres of suede. And it's like,
bingo.
Flippy, real flippy.
Taller when you lie down than you are when you sit up. Is that it?
Well, that's too flippy for me to even
figure out.
Yeah.
You've done some acting in some Western movies.
I'd love to do acting in Western movies. And, your name is in one of my new Western magazines that comes to my palatial estate, Wild Root.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, did you see that about the horse guy? He said you were one of his favorite clients. He was a veterinarian. I don't know. Is in one of
Doug Hertzell, probably.
No, it's the guy that wrote the imprint training book, Miller.
Dr. Miller. Okay,
yeah.
Sure. Listen, I have so many horses that get sick. I just I know every vet in the country, really.
Well, this guy is like, the Eddie Van Halen of vets.
Yes,
you know?
He is.
He's the Chick Akins of vets, folks.
Tell me about... by the way, the guitar player. Who was your guitar player with you?
Joe McMahan.
Yeah, Joe.
He's a Nash Vegan.
What, Roy Rogers. Roy Rogers has had an influence on your life, has he not?
Yeah, I mean, how can he not have had an influence on everybody my age and older's
and
life?
Me, I will tell you, totally. Roy Rogers was the most influential person in my life at one time, he and Gene Autry, because I just, I lived for that. The new comic book would come out.
Did you get them? Yeah. If Roy Rogers said it, boom.
It was there.
Yeah, your papers were in order.
Have you met him?
I did meet him finally, and he was just cool. He was Roy Rogers, and I said, if it hadn't been for you, my mom and dad could have saved a lot of money on the hat, the boots, the horse, the guitar.
That's right.
He said, well, it's funny you say that. I heard these old boys talking one time, and one of them said, I love Roy Rogers, but always hated Dale Evans. And he said, I had to interrupt him and say, gee, what do you mean? He goes, well, we'd play make-believe. My brother would claim you. I had to be Dale.
I always had to be Bullet. I mean, I had a really rough time.
A dog's life.
Yeah. Well, are you aware or were you familiar with or has he had an influence? Will James.
Yeah, late on, I think the cool thing to say is that when you were a kid, you went to the little library at the back of the class and found Smokey the Cow Horse, and read it. And it was there, I'm sure, but I didn't. But in my obsession, I'm into rock and roll, too, folks. This is my sideline as being a drugstore cowboy. But for horses and Western stuff, I kept reading these quotes of Will James. I said, I got to check this guy out. And Will James was a real cowboy and an author and an artist. And in reading a glossary of terms of guys from his genre, I came across this term, carrying the news to Mary, which was a colloquialism to describe a saddled-up, riderless horse running, which indicated to the punchers that the rider may be dead. And it kind of took seed in my mind, and
that's
I wrote some lyrics.
That's a song on the CD, isn't
it?
Yeah. Yeah, carrying the news to Mary. Yeah, Will James was a very interesting guy. I have a collection of his books.
I try to find them. Most of them are out of print. They're coming back.
And they're expensive to find, I'll tell you that. But he went to jail.
Right.
He was in jail for rustling, in fact. But and he was a drunk. I mean, he did drink a lot. But, boy, was he a good artist and quite a cowboy. What is your music?
I call it rock and roll. I think that, it's a mixture of things, and that's what rock and roll is. I think... Aerosmith makes rock and roll, and so does Jerry Lee Lewis, and they don't sound the same, but they're both rock and roll. Yeah. I think, Jerry Lee had a career in country. I think there are elements of country in some of the Beatles songs.
For sure.
I just call it rock and roll.
Well, whatever it is, it's good. And
thank
I hope
you.
You'll do some more for us.
We will. Thanks.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, there he is, Mr. Webb Wilder.
After this break, we're going to hear from Great Divide again, so don't you dare go away. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Primetime Country. Every Thursday night during the summer in Nashville, you can go downtown and do some dancing in the district. That's where Webb Wilder is going to be performing. And on Thursday, July the 11th, that's where you'll be downtown Nashville on July the 11th. On Friday the 12th, he's going to be in Lexington, Kentucky at the Lanai's. And on the 13th in Louisville at the Phoenix Hill Tavern. And here to sing for us, once again, here is Webb Wilder.
Come a little later, don't you think it's time you dried your eyes? Some got you down and loaded, knows I can sympathize. So why'd you even come, and all you're gonna do is mope around? we're gonna rock this town. Let your feet move their mind. Do the dog, do the swim, do the Frankenstein. You're gonna like it a bunch. Come on, everybody, don't you be a sitting on your hands. Find a wallflower, start swinging like old Tarzan. Make a monkey of yourself, be the best you ever felt, I know. I'm a monkey man myself, I'm making peanuts after every show. That's alright, I'm doing fine. You gotta stop and smell the dandelion. You're gonna like it a bunch. Well, rock and roll is getting old and now the god is selling soul. It's my only advice, I don't need liquor, dice or dough. You're gonna like it a bunch.